And you so love a guest, invited or not. Well, welcome, welcome, welcome to the captain's quarters. Warm in here, isn't it? Smells nice, apples and spices. A bit cluttered, I admit, but overall, far sightlier surroundings than that moldy old hold, I'd say. Tell me, just how long were you tucked amongst the barrels before you ratted yourself out with the sneeze? Since sunset, really? That must be some sort of record, I'm sure of it. Most do sneak their way onto my ship tend to be the more, let's say, bumbling sort. Drunken old sod. Got stealth on your side, haven't you? Seem suitably rough-knuckled. I suppose you could have made it entirely undetected, if only that little orange tabby of yours hadn't tickled your senses to the point of sneeze. Not your cat. Well then, what on earth is it doing here? Is it just some stray? Must have taken quite the mighty liking to you, willfully surrounding itself with water like this. Willfully cozying up on your lap like this. You haven't got some tempting treat tucked away in your pockets, have you? No bits of old fish to stick up my cabin. No. Well then, the thing about it is this. I don't know who you are. I don't know what you're doing on my ship. Nor what you intend to do once you get to do wherever it is you're going. But what I do know is this. I don't care to know. No, no, no. I don't particularly care to know any of those things. So you best not waste your breath informing me. I intend no offense, of course. I'm certain that your tale is most riveting, and as dearly as I wish to hear it, I'd simply prefer not to become liable for whatever tomfoolery it is you're getting yourself up to. And at the inevitable I don't know, and I really don't know, and I intend to mean it wholeheartedly, each and every time it passes my lips, do you understand? Good. Now, enough of what I don't care to hear about, let's move on to what I do. You've brought along payment for your patronage, yes? Of course, I'm more than happy to shepherd. So long as you do not give me any trouble, which you will not, correct? Of course. And you do give me something in return for my service, which you will, correct? Of course. Right, let's see it then. Work of one of the Harvington witches, if I'm not mistaken, and I not often am. So which is it? Willow or nightshade? Nightshade, of course, I needn't have asked. I can't imagine Willow will be sending any ally of hers on some fool's errand upstream. Especially not in such his nose with all the little I suppose I am willing to hear just a touch more detail of your travels. Let's see. We've got 8 more stops along this round. Grenfleur, Moonmill, Tottenham Hollow, Moorabbey Docks, Toadport, Rosewood, Lancaster, and Dillyshire. I doubt you've got business in Grenfleur. Lest nightshades actually developed a vested interest in fine cheeses. The Moorabbey Docks exchange is possible, but you don't seem to be caring quite enough to be peddling potions. Could be sinking ingredients in the meadows of Rosewood, I suppose. Nightshade must be sending you on to somewhere she can't possibly go herself. So, Lancaster, I presume. Well, in that case, although you managed to slip your way onto my ship with disturbing ease, I do foresee much greater troubles slipping your way into the city. In exchange for your priceless gift to me, I will be bestowing a priceless gift upon you. Nearly guaranteed safe passage into the city by way of flawlessly forged documentation. No one does it better than I do. Truly. Before I get to fabricating forms, I reckon the first tribulation you post caused me is passing out right here on my desk. You are looking rather faint. I do believe I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, darling. I'll have my apprentice fetch us a bit of bread and wine. Perhaps a little something for your feline stalker as well. Certainly not eager to squander precious rations. But if you were to become famished enough to faint, I'd be liable to handle your catatonic form, and I'd really rather not. So let's keep you well wide and dyed, why don't we? Yes, hardly a good job coming quick. We're in need of a few fixings from the kitchen. You'll fetch a We had him on as a swabby at first, just mopping floors and peeling potatoes in exchange for bread and board. And that was until his uncanny knack for navigation was uncovered. At first I thought he was just doodling for boredom's sake, but upon closer inspection, he was mapping out the cleverest little shortcuts for our next round. Wonderful sense of direction the boy's got. Never once loses his bearings. He's under my wing at the moment, in training to someday take over as sailing master. You know, directing the course, looking after the maps and cartography instruments. There's the old boy himself. Thank you, Hartley. These are the rations we receive each evening. Each member of crew receives bread, berries, cheese, cured meats, and wine. All very delicious and supported to keep our morale high by way of happy bellies. Go ahead. You see, the vast majority of our routes are far too shallow to accommodate the needs of sirens. But just here, at the intersection of the Fenforth and Lancaster River, the waters reach extraordinary depths and harbour the very intricate cave systems sirens so adore dragging their victims down into. So, this very morning I prepared each and every member of my crew with a siren song incantation of immunity. Now that you've joined us and we are rapidly approaching these perilous siren-infested waters, I will gladly provide you with the very same favour. It was taught to me by the Willow Witch herself. Even the sweetest siren song cannot tempt you. Well, while you're enjoying your little sachet of food and drink, I'll be setting to work now. I need to fashion you an entirely convincing letter of safe conduct, transit pass, official identification, all neatly sealed. Far too long since circumstances demanded this particular skill of mine. Quite pleased to be back in my element. I'll first need to select a new name for you. What fun. Let's see what might be fitting. Something distinguished, of course. before. How about Malarian Middleport? Old nemesis of mine. Ghastly woman. Gorgeous name. Perhaps. Opal Whittaker. Do you like that? Opal Whittaker. Any of those feeling particularly suitable for you? Yes, good. I thought much the same. Right then. Here are your complete documents. These should grant you passage without incident. Yes, of course, truly, the least I could do for you relieving us of those merciless adipolis. Well, from here on, it is going to be roughly a 12-hour journey. Stops included and creatures permitting. You'll join me and the crew. But in the meantime, feel free to get your rest. You'll curl up there while I'm busy taking inventory, charting out maps, noting any particular perils the crew need to be aware of, polishing off my cartography tools. Oh my goodness. You would not believe how quickly having nothing at all to do with my forgetting tools on the deck followed by a rainstorm, I assure you. Hardly be a dear to fetch a few blankets for our guest, my own dear. Thank you very much. Let's see the next up is Grenfleur. No, I don't we persuaded him to relocate, allowing him to push the boat around for a bit. He giggled the entire time, thunderously. After Dr. Nam is more